When you go to the movies, do you get a sense of deja vu, like you're watching the same film over and over again? Take, for example, two films hitting our screens this year, Olympus Has Fallen and White House Down. In one film, the hero is a Secret Service agent.
Mustang, this is Big Top, bringing out the full package.
In the other film, the hero is applying for a job as a Secret Service agent.
I can't think of a more important job than protecting the president.
In one movie, terrorists attack Washington, D.C., where the White House and other marble monuments must be saved by a resourceful tough guy. In the other movie, terrorists attack Washington, D.C., and the White House must be saved by a resourceful tough guy. Who is shakier camera work? The only way to tell them apart is that one film has a black guy as president, and the other has a white guy as president. Who's replaced by Morgan Freeman? Who becomes acting president? Note, you're not seeing double. It's a phenomenon in Hollywood known as the coincidence of unoriginality. Great studios think alike, two films with the same unimaginative plot lines fighting for the same box office. After Earth versus Oblivion, Ants versus Bug's Life, and The Prestige versus The Illusionist. It's like two parents fighting over the love of their child in that bleak custody drama, The Good Father, which strangely resembles the bleak custody drama called The Good Mother. Take Taken, a film from the classic genre known as You Kidnap My Daughter, You Deal with an Angry Dad with a Very Particular Set of Skills.
A very particular set of skills.
He's very skillful. Audiences watching Liam Neeson getting angry were so financially successful, the studios just had to abduct another member of his family for Taken 2. Meanwhile, Nicolas Cage's daughter was also kidnapped. It may look like they'd also kidnapped the plot of Taken, but it's not Taken, it's Stolen. Literally, the film is called Stolen. But don't get angry about it, embrace these films. In fact, if you have a spare $1 million, exploit it like these mavericks. A renegade studio known as Asylum have turned reappropriating popular films into an art form. An art form known as the mockbuster. Why watch Indiana Jones and the Kingdom of the Crystal Skull when you can see Alan Quatermain and the Temple of Skulls? Or Transmorphers, or Snakes on a Train, and the Da Vinci Treasure. There's been multiple court cases in America trying to figure out if Asylum is illegal. Maybe this is where Tony Abbott got confused. But is this just the case of the pot calling the kettle a darkish colour resembling but not quite black? Before Hollywood tells others to stop copying their films, they should stop rehashing their own ideas. After all, over the last decade, the highest grossing films have changed from original storylines to remakes, sequels, and adaptations. And in a bizarre twist, things have gone full circle with mockbusters inspiring real life. Aussie billionaire Clive Palmer has decided to build and launch an actual ship called Titanic 2, which will sail the same route as the original Titanic. Or is he just living out the plot of the crappy mockbuster Titanic 2? I hope Clive's ship looks more convincing, but not too much like the movie. But in the end, maybe real life would be more fun if it was just like the movies, and I knew an overprotective dad with a very particular set of skills. Mr. Neeson, can I go out with your daughter?
I will kill you.
Or maybe not.